All right, we're about ready to get things started. I hope everyone is having a fantastic Friday evening. So, I'm doing pretty good myself. And the birdies make their presence known. Yeah! Firstly, yeah, ladies and gentlemen, we got new emotes. I'm still waiting on pending approval for a couple of them. For some reason. I don't know why. But, yeah. Just waiting on pending approval for them. But those were done by the amazing Anna David. You can check them out on Twitter at Davies Art, I believe. Hold on, let me find that. Yep, it is at Davies Art on Twitter. So you go check them out. Get commissions in if you want. I do want to thank I do want to thank you people for these follows. They are Rab Clan, Rab X Fox Blood, and X Fox Fox Blood X. Thank you all for the follows. Thank you for entering the bunker, and there is no escape. But, without further ado, let us jump into the Hellblade. All right. With that being said, hello everyone and welcome to Hellblade: Senua's Sacrifice, a very, very damn good indie game from Ninja Theory. This is my second time playing it. I think my first time I played it was like a few years ago. But yeah. I don't know what else to say other than it's fun, and I'm happy to finally play it here today. So, yeah, we pulled it back a little bit just so we could do that awesome Gundam Evolution collab with McMorgan the Merc. So shout out to my buddy McMorgan, which I will do right now. I am not going to use that shout out thing that Twitch has because I don't like it. Wait a minute. This is the right one, yeah? Yeah, it is. Okay. Just making sure. Okay. Oh, okay. Without further ado, I'm not going to delay any longer. We're just going to go ahead and jump into it. Thank you. The birds say hello. I'm hush.
Hello. Who are you? Doesn't matter. Welcome. You are safe with me. I'll be right here, nice and close, so I can speak without alerting the others. Let me tell you about Senua. Her story has already come to an end, but now it begins anew.
Yeah, I forgot to point that out. This game does touch on mental health issues, more specifically psychosis. They do have a section on their website for that, so. I will put a viewer discretion is advised right now.
There'll be no more stories after this one. Why doesn't she turn back? She's doing this for him. She wants to risk you. They can feel you coming. Quiet. Oh, how rude of me. I never told you of the others. You hear them too, right? They've been around ever since the tragedy. Well, that's not quite true. Some are old, some are new, but they've changed. I think the darkness changed them, just like it changed her. Finally arrived in the land of mist and fog. The place the Northmen call Hell.
Go back. It's not safe. Go back. It's not safe.
It's there. They're here.
Can you see them?
Can you see them? They're going to do that to you.
They're watching.
Stop.
Can you feel them watching? They're watching her.
What is she thinking? I can tell you. She's afraid. Wouldn't you be? You'd think she would get used to it by now after so many years. But the darkness, it just builds onto itself, growing stronger, towering over her. You might try and ignore it. Turn away. But it's always there, just out of sight, where you're most vulnerable. It's like it knows that just enough light is all you need to see its suffocating power.
They can feel you.
You might think she's brave to go on this journey on her own, but it isn't bravery that drives her. Bravery only means something to those afraid of death. Then it was fear runs far, far deeper. What is she looking at? What is she leaving behind? I know what she's thinking. I hear her thoughts. It's not too late to get into the boat and go back. No one will judge her. No one will ever know. There's no going back.
You can't do it.
Senua pushes away a world that conspired to cause so much suffering. There's nothing to go back to, and worse to look forward to. Why don't you join us? Maybe you too have a part to play in this story.
Here we are. Firstly, I just realized I'm gonna do something right quick. Hurry up.
Use your eyes.
Use your eyes.
Come closer.
She can't focus.
Why can't she look focus?
Take a closer look, Senua.
Do not forget my story, Senua. Because your darkness comes from hell, and your fate lies there. They say the burning of a corpse will take you straight to Hela's gate, but gods and the living will follow this path. You must leave the Isles of Orkney across the Eastern Sea and find a road that leads north and down through deep, dark valleys. After 9 nights of riding, you will follow a great river and will find a bridge covered in gold. The path to Helheim goes from there, across the River of Knives that flows from the dark world of Niflheim.
Sorry, I don't even. Yeah. Oh. I'm not trying to talk too much because this is more story driven than what, so.
The old fool was right. What was steps across which lies the halls of hell, the place they call Helheim.
He's lost. Where are you?
There's no doubt about it. The source of the darkness is in Helheim. And the goddess Hela holds his soul there. Her dear beloved, Dillian.
So that's our goal, right there. Got another runestone thing here.
The Northmen speak of nine worlds. The world of men they call Midgard. Sky gods dwell in Asgard. The gods of earth, harvest, wind, and sea dwell in Vanaheim. The good elves dwell in Alfheim. The evil ones dwell in Svartalfheim. The mountain giants dwell in Jotunheim. The fire giants dwell in Muspelheim. Niflheim is the world of ice and darkness. Only the dead dwell in Helheim. And that is where you must travel.
So that is where we're going. We're traveling to the dead realm of Niflheim. Or not Niflheim, Helheim, whoops.
Truth is my truth.
It's good to see you again. You kept your vow.
To guide you in this life and the next. I will tell you my stories of hell, if I may walk with you.
Tell me your stories again, old friend. I'm listening.
The runes seal the gates to hell. Focus your inner eye, and you too will see what's hidden in plain sight.
We follow the truth of truth in this household. These are basically like puzzles. We find the rune and we find something that matches it, like so.
Look towards the gate. And the gate will open.
It's the secret. The gate is open.
Go through it.
No.
I spent 6 years enslaved in hell, but I watched the Northmen, learnt their ways.
I know you did.
You listen when everyone else laughed. My people paid a heavy price. Carry my stories with you, and together we will make the Northmen feel our fury.
Yeah. Feel our fury.
Voice joins us. She once tried to make them go away. Pretend they weren't real. But what good is that? When we are always here.
This game came out, I think, in 2015? 2016? I'm not entirely sure. It still looks fucking beautiful.
Is ruled by the giantess Hela, daughter of Loki. The gods feared her bloodline, bad on her mother's side and yet much worse on her father's. So, as a child, the Allfather cast her down into Helheim and gave her power over those who die of sickness, age, hardship, and self-slaughter. In all of the nine worlds, only Hela can resurrect the dead. To Hela, your Dillion was sacrificed, and with her you must bargain.
So we can gain a little bit more insight on our goal, our end goal basically. We want to go to Helheim, make a bargain with the goddess Hela, in hopes of reviving Senua's beloved Dillion.
Find him. Someone's here. exist anymore. Just give him back.
Oh, shit. Actually need to figure out combat controls real quick. Melee, block, evade. All right, basic stuff.
Vision of what's to come. Poor Senua. The darkness does not bargain. It does not reason. It is rot. And now it has taken hold. It will spread towards her head, the seed of the soul, until there is nothing left of her. All of her suffering will have been for nothing. It's just a matter of time.
Dark rot will grow each time you fail. If the rot reaches Senua's head, her quest is over. And all progress will be lost. There we have it. We just cannot die.
Battles are fought in the mind. That is what Dillian taught her. With every defeat, dark rot will grow, and soon it will take her soul. But for now, at least, she still has control of her mind. And she will fulfill her vow, whatever the cost.
Listen to me, Senua. The goddess Hela lies behind the gate to Helheim. To open the illusion. Valravn. Spill their blood to open the gate to Helheim and enter the land of the dead.
Yep. Look at just another. Ah, okay. Just making sure. So this game has basically a dynamic difficulty to it, where basically if you begin to basically suck a bunch of times, the game will be easier for you. But if you start to do really fucking good, the game will get harder for you. But we got another rune.
In the beginning, there was nothing but darkness. Bitter cold to the north, fiery hot to the south. They say the cold formed ice, which melted from the sparks from the south. The power of the darkness gave life to the dripping ice, and the first giant was born and was named Ymir. The ice continued to drip, and the power of the void gave life to it, and it became a cow whose milk fed the giant. That's right, a cow, but you weren't expecting that.
Interesting. Okay, who do we want to face? This is Surt, I believe, and that is Valravn. Well, I mean, I guess we're picking Valravn. Okay.
Surt.
Oh, nope, that's Surt.
The giant has answered. He comes from a land older than mankind. And the Northmen call upon his flaming sword to raise their enemies to the ground.
Alright, fuck it, you know what? All right, fuck it. We're facing Surt.
She found the wretched old fool on her way back from the wilds. An outcast, was badly burnt all over. She took pity on him, for he was not born to this world. Like her, who spoke of his own darkness. The Northmen.
Walk these lands, gazing towards different horizons, some of us further than others. Your father cannot see what you see, but there is nothing wrong with seeing the world the way you do. Senua. We each walk these lands, gazing
at different
horizons. Some of us further than others. Your father cannot see what you see, but there is nothing wrong with seeing the world the way you do.
Well, I want to go down there and see if there's anything down here to get. Aha, there is something over here to get. A rune.
The Northmen tell this story. Before the Earth was created, there was a world called Muspel. Because it was in the south, it was bright and hot, flaming, burning. Sparks that flew out from Muspel became the stars. Other sparks melted ice in the frozen world of Niflheim, creating the body of the first giant, Ymir. Muspel is one of the nine worlds, and is now the land of the fire giants. And people from elsewhere cannot endure a journey there.
A little bit of history in the world of the realm of Muspelheim. Oof. Yeah, fuck you, boy. There we go. Yeah, fuck you. All right, now we have two symbols that we have to, or two runes we have to try and match up. Now we have one more rune we need to find. I do like the game does basically let you know when you're close to finding said rune. Like so.
The path to Helheim is sealed for the living, but you already walk amongst the dead. Look towards the gate, and you will see that it has opened. I knew enough of their tongue to beg for mercy, and they took me as a slave. I wish now that they had slaughtered me like the others. I rode their storm of fire, death, and slavery to many lands. This darkness you speak of? I know it well.
And I'm still here to fight it.
There we go, here we go again. Oh shit.
It's nearly over. What you can ignore.
God damn.
When you see a fire gate of Surt, know that only a sacrifice will stoke the fires of Muspel and let the dead walk through. Find the fire, Senua, to follow the path to Surt.
She get through.
She'll need to find another way.
Truth and scent. Find your own path.
There's always another way.
There's always a way.
The Northmen say that the defender of Muspel is called Surt, the foremost of the fire giants. His name means the Black One, because he is like something burnt. The Northmen believe that he sits at the border of Muspel with his flaming sword. And at the end of the world, he will leave his post. He will travel to Asgard and Midgard, waging war against all the gods. He will be victorious, and then burn the whole world with fire.
Will it by chance be a holy fire? Just a question.
Northmen believe that the world will be destroyed someday. They call it Ragnarok, the destiny of the gods. Asgard will be attacked by Surt and the fire giants. A monstrous wolf will swallow the sun, and the gods will fight in vain against their enemies. There is nothing they can do to prevent it, but Odin ever seeks knowledge and magic, hoping to find a way to postpone that dark day.
The Northmen made fire sacrifices, burning slaves like me to reveal the path to Surt. I searched for meaning in their suffering, in their eyes. But they just screamed like helpless pigs.
Just exploring a little bit. See if there is anything else, any rooms I can get, but nope.
Answer your prayers, Senua. I asked the gods for mercy, all of them, even theirs. None answered. In the end, I set myself free. Defy the gods, Senua. Find your own path, like I find mine.
My gods abandoned me. I am alone.
I forgot that some of the characters in this game have like actual IRL actors. Or some of the scenes they appear in, it's really neat. I like it. I like it when games do a mix of that.
The Northmen say that at Ragnarok, the sons of Muspel will travel to battle in the ship called Naglfar, the corpse ship. And when the sons of Muspel leave the ship and ride to battle, it will be as though the sky had split open, and Surt will lead them. Wherever he goes, flame will erupt before him, and fires will burn behind him.
Whoa, what's in here? Oh, it's probably something I have to go through later. Is this another gate that requires another sacrifice?
Insatiable gods of darkness. I come from Erin, Senua, where I once followed my own gods, the Tuatha De Danann.
Why did you abandon your gods?
Senua, I was a man of knowledge, not a warrior. To survive, I did things. Bad things. Like you, Senua, the man I once was has died. And when that happens, even gods you worship can die with you.
Oh, that's charming. Oh! Ain't that convenient? All right, here we go. There we go.
You say your world has collapsed. Good. Let it collapse and have the courage to shed your tears. Raise your world.
Run! My world is dead.
Only then, as with a newborn, will you see the world anew?
No, I see nothing now.
Door won't budge.
Say that what we see as a rainbow is the bridge that goes from the world of men to the world of the gods. For now, they say the frost giants and the mountain giants cannot cross it. But they say that when Ragnarok comes, not a thing in this world will be safe. The rainbow bridge will break under the onslaught of the fire giants riding on flaming steeds. Senua, I have seen the fire of Surt spread far and wide, and to our lands. Ragnarok is coming.
All right. Now we have three runes we need to find.
Tell me, Drew. How did you escape your darkness?
Senua, once I found my purpose, I was no longer enslaved to the suffering I had to endure to reach it. Unclouded by fear, I can see it clearly.
I'm glad I found you in the wilds. I wouldn't have made it without you.
Okay, hold on. Oh! There we go. Through the fire and flames, baby.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. This darkness takes everything. Everyone.
Senua. Are you sure you want to do this? We can fight this together, side by side.
my battle. I have to face it alone, away from here.
Where will you go?
I don't know.
For how long?
I don't know.
I believe in you. You know that. Just promise me that you will come back to me. I want you to say it. I want you to say it.
I will come back to you. I promise.
Here he is.
You destroyed everything, everyone, but not me. Fight me now.
Ah, shit. There we go! Oh, fuck! There we go. Search has been slain.
called Fall. Even the gods have their time. Yet we still go on. Why?
I made a promise. And I will go to hell to keep it.
I die free, knowing you will carry my stories with you.
Yes, you have.
When the darkness comes, I vow to guide you in this life and the next to fulfill yours.
Then I will see you in hell.
Be ready to face horror in the eye as I have, to find your answers. Your quest. Your truth.
Truth was a troubled man. Scholar turned slave. They tortured him. Took him with them on their raids. Spreading this new form of darkness to new worlds. To my world. Senua saw a deep connection form between the Northmen and the darkness. His tales of hell were true. And that was the source of it. She learned everything she could from him. Until she too could see what he saw. Died before? It's a serious question. When the illusion of self is shattered, you simply cease to be. Though it may not seem that way to others, you know when it is true. You can feel it. A stranger in your own body. An imposter. And nothing is the same ever again. Someone has died. And she will do so again. You can be sure of that.
Does this say the same thing?
Senua. We each walk these lands. Horizons. Some of us further than others. Your father cannot see what you see, but there is nothing wrong with seeing the world the way you do.
New enemies, this time with the maces. Fuck!
Get up quickly! She's hurt. She's injured. She won't make it.
There we go.
No, this is nearly the end.
Yeah, why not?
She can't.
Why?
She's only done one test.
Just one.
She's only passed one test.
What's the other test?
Is there a test?
What is
it? Alright, now we have to go take on the God of Illusions, Valraven.
Sons and grandsons were dark after him. Of his daughters and granddaughters, some were monstrous, but others fair. But there was another who came from the ice, Buri. In shape, he was like a man, big and powerful. His son, Bor, took a fair giant to be his wife, and they had three sons. Odin was the eldest, and the Northmen hold him to be the foremost of the gods. The old father.
Outside is a bridge.
She tried. Beg.
see you too.
I didn't even mean to activate that, but you know, it's appreciated. Hell yeah. Combat's fun.
She will find what she's looking for.
Valravn's power of illusion comes from ravens. Align the ravens to break his magic seal.
Show me what you have seen, Truth.
Look how much has changed.
Into another world that looks the same but feels different. An impostor world where the forest itself is watching.
Well, can't you see?
challenge me.
Ah.
Before the tragedy, she journeyed into the wilds of her native land, living off berries, roots, and rabbits. Uncommon, you see. We call such a person a Geralt. Some, like Druth, become Geralt in search of penance. Others, like Senua, to purge a curse. Those who make it back are forever changed. The worst kind comes without warning. A deep and primal signal from within. A reminder that just because you cannot see the threat, it doesn't mean that it's not already here.
Oh, Jesus. Come on.
You can do this. Take him. Go again. Down. Behind you.
Oh, fuck. Hey there, Gaijin. Yes, they're coming from hell, but instead of being HE double hockey stick, it is HE one hockey stick.
The Northmen say that Odin and his brothers killed Ymir, and that the world of man was formed from his corpse. They made his bones into stone, and his flesh into earth, and his blood into the salt sea. They set his skull to be the bowl of the sky, with his brains for clouds. Odin and his brothers caught the sparks flying from Muspel and made them into stars. And to protect the new world from the giants, they used Ymir's great curving eyebrows as walls.
Interest.
Do you know what it's like to leave everything behind? Your home? Loved ones, to head deep into the wilds, perhaps never to return. Senua does. Because when darkness speaks, it changes everything. Turning home into a foreign land and loved ones into strangers. Exile makes sense when you realize. That you were never really home in the first place.
The Northmen is always in search of knowledge and wisdom and magic. There was a very wise being named Mimir who guarded the waters of wisdom which flow from the roots of the world tree. Odin wished to drink from this spring, but he had to pay a price. So he gouged out his own as offering to Mimir. He drank from the well and traded one way of seeing for another.
Thank you.
Reminds her of somewhere.
The forest.
Where? Which forest? Forest in the wilds.
The wilds.
She left the moon.
She went to the wilds a long time ago.
Why did she go to the wilds?
She wanted to fight her own darkness. She thought she could beat her own darkness.
Did she beat her darkness?
No. It nearly killed her, but she tried.
Druth. Druth helped her.
If it wasn't for Druth, she'd be dead.
She can't beat her own darkness. She wanted to marry Dillian. She came to beat her own darkness and marry Dillian. But she didn't work.
She thought her curse would affect him.
She thought her curse would spread to him.
She thought she'd bring the darkness to him too.
She nearly died.
She thought the curse made her tainted.
The Northmen say you must sacrifice in order to receive. They tell how the runes were revealed to Odin only in sacrifice. He hung himself from the world tree, and he stabbed himself with a spear, and he dedicated the sacrifice to himself. For 9 nights he hung on the tree without food or drink, and at last he saw the runes below him. He gave a cry and gathered them in his mind and learnt them. Then he fell from the tree.
Definitely cannot go that way. Can't go that way either. Oh, okay.
The ravens. They've gone.
They've gone.
No.
Half of them have gone.
They've gone.
Some still there.
But where?
Some still there.
The ravens helping.
He's not helping.
It's a trick.
Quiet,
Troy.
Out in the wilds.
She no longer felt fit for this world. She almost gave in to the darkness. But she remembered Dillian's words. She remembered her promise. She resolved to fight on and kill that which had become a part of her.
Oh, okay. I just noticed that.
Where have they gone?
She did it.
Looking back, I was so naive to think she could banish it on her own. The further she saw into the darkness, the more she struggled to see anything at all. And the glow, the smallest hints of shape, sound, or thought, grew in strength until they consumed her. She knew it. The darkness had her in its claws.
Broken. The gate is open.
Open.
There is no such thing as victory when it comes to the darkness. It's like it doesn't want to kill them. Yet, on the water, biding its time. Only when she is at her weakest. She find Dillian before her time comes.
All right. Go.
Overcome Valravan's final illusion to face him in his keep. I know you can do it, Senua. You have the sight.
We both see the darkness. We can fight it together.
Ooh, fire. Pretty fire.
Speak to me, Drew. Tell me a story.
Senua, listen. I will tell you the tale of a man called Findon. The Northmen captured Findon's sister and his father sent him to pay for her release. But they took his gold, put him in chains, and held him for a day and a night without food or water. Then they released him. I don't know why. Upon his return, his father's enemies in Erin set fire to his home. His father burnt to death, and his brother was killed. But he escaped with sorrow in his heart. His father's enemies offered redress for his loss and invited him to a feast. It was at a hall near the sea. But when he went there, they betrayed him to the Northmen, who enslaved him and took him to hell. 6 years later, his slave masters landed on the shores of Orkney, burning all before them. And into that fire, Findon made his escape. What was Findon burnt away that day? But from the flames, a new man stepped forward, and Druth was born. Druth, the man that I am now. And though Findon never set eyes on his dear sister again, I, Druth, have found you, Senua.
I wish you could have seen my home before these dark times.
Drop the bridge.
The gate is open! Open!
This darkness. I know it from the wilds. It's coming back for me.
Peekaboo.
Fear. Deeper. Deeper. Dragging you down so far into the void that maybe this time there is no coming back. But there, in the darkness,
Senua.
She remembered what he told her.
Hear me. Reach out to me. Senua. Take my iron mirror. Look into it. For it is a window into the underworld. Within, you will see the face of the darkness that you fear. And if you focus like I have taught you to, you will also see that as much as the darkness has you trapped within its veil, it too is trapped within yours. Focus. Focus. Focus.
I see you. I see you now. You led me to the wilds. You trapped me there.
I do remember having a bit of a problem with Valraven the first time I played this. I actually died. Fuck. Yep, fuck you, mate. Whoa, that was weird.
Focus. The only way.
Here we go.
Closer to defeat. Unfair, isn't it? In those dark winter nights in the wilds, there were times when she considered letting go. If it weren't for Druth, a chance encounter in the wilds, she would not have heard his stories of the Northmen. She would not have this chance to find Dillian's soul.
I'm coming. I still hear you.
Time to get the hell out of this place.
When she was younger, she would lay in the grass and stare at the clouds. And there she saw them. Elusive. Shifting faces. After a while, she could see the face of everyone. The trees. The mountains. Caves.
You have the sight, just like I do. Once you can see into the underworld and all the souls within it will see you. Don't be afraid when they speak to you. I will always be here to guide you.
Did you see her? That was her mother, Galina. She was a priestess, a healer. She taught Senua to see the weave that binds the world together. And it was beautiful. It was a time before the darkness. But when it did come, it first came for her mother. Senua still sees her face from time to time, hidden in the rock. Like she's still watching over her. She misses her so much.
And the mark of Surt, you may cross the bridge over the River of Knives to Helheim.
Why is she waiting? Open the gate!
No, it's dangerous, don't open the gate.
She's done it.
It's so dark.
It's dark, the dark.
Only the dead may cross.
Only the
There is no one here but me.
Not you.
Did you think that I would let you go? That you lost me back in the wilds? I will never let you go. You can't get rid of me. I am your shadow. And I will be watching when you draw your last dying gasp.
I'm not ready to die.
You will be when you see what they did to your dear beloved.
Damien!
In this waking nightmare, where all dreams come true, you searched for control, a way to pull through. When you were in love, you left him in tears to smother your furies and banish your fears. But in darkness they came. Through stormy black seas they raided these shores. Do you still hear his screams? And now that you're home, he's so far away. They've taken his soul. To these gods you cannot pray. They can break you, but not your promise. Even death won't keep you apart. Through his darkness you will find him. In your sword still beats a heart. You fought for love unspoiled by your darkness within. You fought for your dreams. Now there's no way to win. In the head of his corpse lies the seat of his soul. So you must carry his vessel to bring him back home. They can break you, but not your promise. Even death won't keep you apart. Through this darkness you will find him. In your sword still beats a heart. See it in the hollows of your eyes. A gaze averted from life. You ran from it but brought it nearer. Led it to him. An endless suffering worse than death. And you wanted to surrender, abandon him to find peace with the gods. No. The darkness won't allow it. So you will walk into the lair of the beast. Look it in the eye, and you will go to war. This is your mission. This is your quest. There is nothing else left.
All right, and with that being said, we have opened up the gate, crossed the bridge into Helheim, but that is where we are going to have to end it for this first part of Hellblade: Senua's Sacrifice. So this will continue next week on Thursday. I believe so. Yeah, it'll be should be continuing next Thursday unless I have other plans set. Thursday and Friday, Hellblade. Obviously tomorrow we got WPW Saturday Night Showdown, which will obviously be continuing next Saturday as per usual. And I am gonna go and send you guys over to Edward Bosco. MNW Friday Night Flashbang is currently going on. It just started, so we're gonna do that. And yes, this game is absolutely amazing. Like, if you haven't played this yet, I highly encourage you do so. It is fucking amazing. I love this game. I love it so much. But we're gonna raid Ed. The raid message is the bounty hunter arrives in all caps. So with that being said, that's where I'm going to end it for tonight. If you guys enjoyed what you've seen, if you haven't already, don't forget to give me a follow over here on Twitch. Turn on notifications for Navarro Go Live. There are links below to follow me on both Instagram and Twitter so you get notified of any stream updates and announcements that I may have. There's also a link to my YouTube channel that you can subscribe to, because that's where I post the VODs for the Mountain Blade Monday series, as well as the main playthroughs I do for the channel, as well as WPW Saturday Night Showdown. If you missed the VODs of any of my previous series, you can go to the YouTube channel and watch those. But that's where we're going to end it. Again, tomorrow, WPW. Next Thursday and Friday, more Hellblade. And next Saturday, more WPW. So, yeah. Thank you all so much for watching. Hope you all have a fantastic Friday night, evening, morning, whatever the case may be. And I will see you guys tomorrow for the next episode of WPW Saturday Night Showdown. Have a good night, everyone, and see ya.